Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about faster btree index scans in Postgres 17 for queries that involve end lists or other cases where multiple array values are being passed to Postgres. Now, this commit by Peter Geoghegan with co-author Matthias van der Mint recently landed in Postgres 17, but there's been a lot of back and forth over the last months in terms of testing, benchmarking, and revising the approach. So I think the chances are pretty good that this will stay in the final release, but as always with these changes before September or October this year, we won't know for sure if this will actually land. Now, this commit message talks about what are called scalar array operator expressions. You could say that's an end list, where you have multiple fixed values that are being provided by the client that Postgres will look up in the index in order to find the result. Same goes for column equals any with a list of values or other operators like not in or the all operator. Now, one of the main ideas here is that this takes the previous commit by Tom Lane back in 2011 a lot further, which initially enabled btree indexes to be smarter about index scans and index-only scans in relation to these scalar array operator expressions. Now, the first improvement here is that an SAOP scan will now reliably avoid duplicative leaf page access. Now, that means previously, before this commit, Postgres would repeatedly traverse the btree index just to potentially get to the exact same page again, because it wasn't able to work with multiple values at a time. The idea is that now this array of input values is considered when we're working with a particular page, and so we can potentially get the next value without having to retraverse the whole tree. That's a pretty big improvement just in terms of repeated page accesses. Before we jump into an example of that, I also want to highlight to you one important documentation change to clarify something that I didn't know before, which is pgsetAllIndexes, which is one of the internal statistics tables, has an index scan counter. The same counter exists also per table. And Peter, as part of this commit, added a clarification note where he said queries that have these arrays of multiple scalar values can perform multiple primitive index scans. Now, what does primitive mean here? It essentially means that you're accessing the btfirst function in the btree code multiple times. That's essentially where it starts a new traversal of this btree structure. And so the idea is previously, if you had an in list with multiple values, for each of the values, it would increment the index scan counter, which means the index scan counter actually means how oftentimes this btfirst function was executed, which started the traversal of a btree index. Now in Postgres 17, we'll see this be lower in many cases because of these changes. Let's take a look here. So I have Postgres 16 running as well as the latest development build of Postgres 17. I'll create a simple test table here, and I'll just insert 10,000 values into this test table. Now I'll run an explain analyze buffers on that table with 7 values. You'll see here that Postgres tells me that there's 15 shared hit pages. Now let me check how many index scans I did. We can see that here we had 7 of these primitive index scans of the btfirst function being called. Now let's take a look at Postgres 17. And the first change you'll notice is that here, instead of 15 pages being hit, we only have 3 pages being hit. More importantly, you can see that the index scan counter is just 1 now instead of 7. This shows that fundamental change where now, because the individual index scan already can process everything at once, it doesn't need to do the whole work again. Now, in some test cases where you have long in lists, even this change alone might sometimes make significant improvements of 20%, 30%, just if you're CPU bound on these page accesses. It's very workload dependent if such a simple query sees a benefit, but generally speaking, there's going to be less contention on these internal buffer locks where you're accessing the same page multiple times. Now, the big improvement here are what Peter in the mailing list discussion called MDAM techniques. MDAM stands for multidimensional access methods. And that's based on a 1995 paper, Efficient Search of Multidimensional B-Trees, which introduced a couple of concepts that essentially relate to how do we traverse B-tree index structures. Now, back then, almost 30 years ago, they were also already talking about end lists. And so they have an example that might look very much like a query that you run these days. So this concept is where Peter's work essentially started. As Peter describes here, the most compelling use cases for this change is when you have multiple index columns with multiple scalar array operator clauses. So this means that you have in list of values and then other column in list of different values. Now that's a lot more efficient. Also, additionally, if you're doing scans where you don't scan for the leading column, but you use the leading column, for example, for sort, Postgres will now be able to do things much more efficiently. This also relates to the discussions around index skip scans. So the simplest example here given in the Postgres wiki is imagine you have an index on two columns, order ID, product ID, and you're searching for product ID, but then you're returning the order ID to the client. So you're getting a benefit from that order ID being indexed. Maybe other queries are using that, but really your filter is not on that. And so now if this works, this is also going to be more efficient. And I want to show you one real life example that community member Benoit provided to Peter as part of working on this. And I think this is a great example where Benoit put together a working example that the community can take and use to iterate on a particular patch. So if you find yourself reporting something to the Postgres community, please follow what Benoit did here and make a reproducer that Postgres developers can actually run. So Benoit provided a setup script. I've already run this locally. And I'm just going to run the explain analyze. I'm just going to show you the difference between 16 and 17. So in 16, this runs in about 270 milliseconds. On 17, this runs in an amazing 62 milliseconds. And one of the main differences here for this particular query, in 16, it was using the index for its sort order, but it wasn't using the index for filtering directly, but essentially applying that after it got the data from the index. Versus on 17, it's able to use that directly in the index condition. And so I think this is a great real-world example where without making any changes to your index structure, just by being smarter about how the index is being used, we can see a tremendous 3x performance improvement. Thank you, Peter and Matthias, for working on this change. Well done, Benoit, for providing a good working test case. I'm excited about using this on my own databases. I can already see that I'll have a few cases where this will provide noticeable performance improvements for btree index scans. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.